I was watching Paul Hibbert's Beginner's Guide to Setting Up Home Assistant a few weeks ago, and one of the things he said got me thinking. He said that the easiest way to get both remote access and Alexa integration working with Home Assistant is to sign up and pay for the monthly Home Assistant cloud subscription. He's totally right, of course, and I've said that before too. In the case of Alexa integration, it's an absolute ball ache to set up and get working. It's totally rock solid once it is working, but a massive hassle, and there are a great many videos out there talking you through that already. But remote access, specifically secured remote access, is actually very easy to set up, if a little bit of a long-winded process. Yeah, you can just open up a port on your router and forward it straight through to your Home Assistant server if you want, but that would be totally unencrypted and transmit your passwords and other data in plain text for everyone to see. You could also just use the Let's Encrypt add-on and use the default Home Assistant port 8123 for encrypted access. But again, this can cause a lot of issues with certain integrations. If you add encryption to the default port, then that means that unencrypted access is no longer possible. If any devices on your local network want to talk to Home Assistant, then they must be capable of ignoring invalid certificates, because your certificate will not be valid when accessing directly by IP address instead of the external hostname. So this is how the solution I'm proposing is going to work. First of all, we're going to use dynamic DNS to provide us with a hostname on the internet. Then we're going to install a special proxy server add-on in Home Assistant which listens for external encrypted connection requests, which will be secured with a free Let's Encrypt certificate. We'll configure your router to port forward that encrypted traffic through to your new proxy server, and that proxy server passes traffic through to the unencrypted Home Assistant server internally. So your end solution has unencrypted internal access on the original port 8123 and encrypted external access on port 8126. Here we go. First thing to do is to sign up with Duck Dns. I'm signed in using my Google account. There are quite a few options you can use, but once you've got signed up with it, you just need to create a subdomain. So I'm going to create one here, and you can see it's been added to my account already. Then you need to take the token from there and copy it to your clipboard. Over in Home Assistant, you want to go to the add-on store and search for the Duck DNS add-on. Install that. Head on over to the configurations tab, and in the domains box, you need to add the domain that you registered earlier, which in my case is that. Remove the unused one. For the token, you need to paste in the token from your account, from your Duck DNS account, and then accept terms value down in this Let's Encrypt section must be changed to true. You click on save, go back to the info tab and start it. This should actually give you an external hostname and register you a Let's Encrypt SSL certificate at the same time. Okay, and this is the log just to show that it has registered the certificate. Next, we've got the trickiest part of the process for me to talk you through, because you need to visit your router's web interface and forward a port through externally to allow access to Home Assistant. On my Asus router here, and every single router is different, which is what makes this quite tricky to talk you through, you can see I forwarded port 8126 through to the internal IP address of my Home Assistant server, which in this case is 192.168.1.13. Back over on Home Assistant, we've got to install another add-on now, and this time we're going to install Nginx, just like that. And you can see Home Assistant SSL proxy. And I'll click on install and leave that to go for a second. Okay, once it's installed, you've got to do a bit of configuration first. So we visit the configuration tab and we type in the hostname that we registered before. And we need to change this active value here from false to true. Then, very importantly, we click on this save button here. Now we can scroll down a bit more to network, change port 443 to 8126, which is what we forwarded through our router. Click on save, back up to info, and we can start it. Once this is up and running, we now need to do a bit of YAML configuration editing. And the easiest way to do this is to install the file editor add-on. So back to the add-on store, go and install file editor and install. And once that's installed, you need to go to the configuration tab, and I suggest you turn off enforce base path. That'll let you get access to every single file on the whole Home Assistant server. Turn that off, save it, back over to info, click on start, and conveniently you can tick this little box here, which will show file editor in the sidebar as well. You can now visit file editor and choose your configuration YAML, which I'm just showing you here, but it is already open just here. And then you need to add in a little bit of configuration, and just like this. And all this is saying is that Home Assistant will allow you to forward requests to it, and it trusts forwarded requests from these proxies. Now this proxy is actually the Nginx subnet, so it should now let us save it. We go down to developer tools, check the configuration is working, and I'm going to restart this and I'll see you on the other side. Okay, so we've rebooted, we're all back up and running. Now we need to tell Home Assistant about its new external URL. And to do that, we have to enable advanced mode. So you go down to your profile at the bottom and tick the option that says advanced mode. And this will open up some more options for you. In settings, system and network, you can now scroll down and you can paste in your new external host name and port. Click on save and you should now be good to go. So if I just show you at the top here, we're currently running on 192.168.1.13 port 8123, and you can see it's not secure. But if I now open up a new tab and paste in the new URL, there we go, we're logged in and we are using a secure certificate on port 8126. If you're an ESP home user, then there is one more bit of configuration that you need to perform before you can get that add-on working properly externally. So just visit the file editor plugin again and back out from config and find the folder called share. And in the share folder, you need to upload a file with this exact file name. And I'll just show you the contents right now. Restart the Nginx proxy server after you've saved this file and you'll be good to go. As you can see, there's a lot to cover in order to set this up properly, but hopefully this guide has made it a bit easier for you. As always, I will put all of the details up on my website and I'll put a link to that down in the description. If you found this video useful, then I'd really appreciate you hitting the like button, and please subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this one. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.